Hi folks. So I have completed the Batik quilt top, and just a reminder, this is for the couch, so it's kind of narrower than it would normally be. And my backing fabric arrived yesterday, and my batting a few days before that, so now I can put everything together and pin it.
First thing I'm going to do is tape the edge. I'm going to just follow the line of the floor here. So I'll have one really good straight line, and then I'll go around after that. I'm alternating tape going parallel and tape going orthogonal because I think this way probably holds a little bit better, but this way holds a longer section. I don't know if there's any actual facts to that, but it just feels right.
Hello, cat on grass. Please don't help me.
This is Kiki, one of my helpers. Okay, don't knock that over. All right, I'm probably getting to the end where I need to be. Let's see. Oh yeah, I'll just do a little bit more. Oh yeah, that's plenty good. Alrighty. And I have a nice fold line here to cut along. So that's good. Alrighty. Now I'm gonna finish taping. Unfortunately, there's not a line of the wood exactly where I want it to be, but I keep an eye on this distance and try and make that parallel all the way along. I should be good. I think I'm going to start from the middle. So if I make an error, if I start at the end, it'll just exaggerate it. Whereas if I start in the middle, it should be better. I want this to be smooth. Not like super-de-dupes tight, but just nice and smooth. It would probably have been a good idea for me to iron this first, but shockingly, I'm too impatient. Just want to get her done. Get to the fun part. Alrighty, and now I'm gonna do the ends, and again, starting from the middle. Alrighty, so now the batting. I just do it double thickness, and then I don't have to do any cutting either. Ooh, this may not be long enough. Pooh bears. Okay. All right, that'll work. Let me just see. Well, if I take it right to the edge, that'll work. All right, so I'm just gonna do like before and tape along this edge and on all the other ones. Now the batting isn't gonna hold the tape super well, so I'm just gonna have to be careful when I smooth things around. that I don't pull the tape off. Hey, Kiki. Are you helping? I'm only doing the orthogonal tape on the batting because it really doesn't hold very well, and I find when I do the parallel tape, it just comes right off. It's too much fuzzies. Alrighty, now I think I'm gonna do the smaller end and follow that straight line because I'm gonna need to cut there and here. So I want to establish a really good right corner. Alrighty. I just put a little cut halfway up there just so I know what to aim for. And now I'm going to trim this. I'm going about an inch and a half from the edge of the backing fabric. Normally I would do the backing fabric bigger, the batting next in, maybe an inch, and then the top fabric in again. But the backing fabric and the top of the quilt are very similar in size, so I can't really do that, and I want to make sure that I have enough batting right to the edge of the quilt, so I'm going a little over on the batting. So I found with the tree quilt, there were areas where I had to trim off the quilt top more than I wanted to, just because I didn't have enough batting, and that's not great. This doesn't have to be exact or anything, it's just to get the bulk out of the way. I'll be trimming everything afterwards anyway. Alrighty, last side. I think this is just the batting stretching a little bit at the edge. Hoping this isn't going to be a problem, but we'll see. Okay, here we are, the last part. Okay, this is good. This looks like I am going to have enough background fabric. So what I wanted to do was have a good inch and a half, couple inches, so that instead of making bias tape, I could flip over the backing. And put that on. I don't know why this isn't trimmed. Maybe I just missed a side. Looks like I missed a side. Alright, well. Good. Okay, now I'm just going to tape this one down. I don't want to tug too hard here, because I don't want to pull up tape from over there. There's some parts here that are a little bumpy or not quite lined up, and I think that's just a variation in the hemming distance. So when I'm quilting it, I'm just going to try and flatten it out and quilt it like that instead of opening up the seam and keeping it equidistant from the seam, but then having a bump over, have it equidistant from the fold, if that makes sense. Okie dokie, now it's time to pin. So I'm gonna start in the middle and work out. And I wanna make sure that I'm getting through to the bottom as well, but I also don't wanna scrape the floor. Alrighty, one. If I put the pin in the middle of a block, then I won't have to move it when I'm quilting. Okay, I think I've got everywhere pretty well done. So now I'm going to go around and pin the very edges. Okay. No, this isn't an edge, but this guy wants to be there. I think two per block is probably going to be fine. I think three will be better. Come on, you can do it. Yay! Okay, so now I think I'm just going to trim the batting back, not the background fabric though. I'm not going right up against the fabric of the top, just in case, giving myself about a quarter of an inch. This side's really uneven. Again, it doesn't have to be too exact. Some of my edges are really not very straight, so I'll probably have to clip back some anyway. I just want to get rid of most of the bulk here. Alrighty, so now I can trim up a little bit from here. I want to leave 2 or 3 inches. Alrighty, so there we are. Now it's just a matter of pulling off all the tape. Yay! So I'll get back to you when this is on the quilt frame, and then we can start quilting.
Thanks for joining me today, and I will see you again when I've got this on the frame, and then we can start quilting. Okay, see you soon. Bye-bye.